Hello everyone, welcome to Talent Battle. This video is related to our campaign Ask Your Doubt and Get a Video Solution. In this video, we will be solving questions asked by some students from various parts of our country. If you are also having any doubt or question related to aptitude, you can check a Google form link in the description of this video and you can ask your doubts over there. But before that, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and like this video, as we will be posting all the videos on our YouTube channel. So let's start with the question. This particular question was asked by Jasbir Singh from UIET College. The question is, a property was originally on a 99 years lease and 2/3 of the time passed is equal to the 4/5 of the time to come. How many years are there to go? Now the question can become easy if you just write down the proper equation. If you check, the property was originally on 99 years lease, so the total time period for the property is 99 years. 2/3 of the time passed. So what I will do, I will consider time passed as x years. Okay, so time passed, I will consider x years have passed, and time to come, then it will become 99 minus x, so still 99 minus x years are to come. So what is the equation they have given? 2/3 of the time passed, so 2 by 3, time passed we have considered as x, so into x, is equal to 4/5, so 4 by 5, of time to come. Time to come is nothing but 99 minus x, so 99 minus x. Now just you need to solve this equation, what will happen? 5 into 2 is 10x, 4 into 3 is 12, 12 into 99, that will be the first thing you need to do, minus 4 into 3, 12, into x is 12x. 12x will go on the left side and it will become positive, so 22x is equal to 12 into 99. So if you calculate x, it will be 12 into 99 divided by 22. So 6 into 2, 11 into 2, 11 into 1, 11 into 9, x will be 6 into 9, which is 54 years. So time passed, I can say 54 years are passed. And what they have asked, how many years are there to go? So time to come is nothing but 99 minus x, value of x is 54, 99 minus 54 is 45. So still 45 years are there to go. So answer for this question will be A. This particular question was asked by Vinay from GN College. The question is, a shopkeeper selling the rice at a profit of 20%. However, he was unaware of the fact that his weighing machine was tampered and showed 950 grams for 1 kilogram. Find the actual profit. Now, as you can check, initially the shopkeeper was selling at 20% profit. And later on, he realized that rather than selling 1000 gram, like 1 kg, he was selling only 950 grams. So additional 50 grams profit was there. So find the actual profit. So what I will do, to keep it simple, I will consider 1000 grams for 1000 rupees. Okay. Suppose he has purchased 1000 grams of rice at 1000 rupees. So initially he was selling it at a profit of 20%. So what will be his selling price? As you can calculate it orally also, if 20% profit is there on 1000 rupees, so I can say his selling price is 1200 rupees. Next, however, he was unaware that the machine was tampered and showed 950 grams for a kilogram weight. So he has only purchased, I can say, or the cost price we need to consider only for 950 grams. We cannot consider the cost price for 1000 grams because the machine was showing or the 950 grams only for a kilogram weight. So cost price of 950 grams according to this logic will be 950 rupees. Now, what they have asked? They have asked us profit percentage. The formula for profit percentage, as we know, it is the profit divided by the CP into 100. What will be profit in this case? As you can check, ultimately he has sold it at 1200 rupees. And the cost price for the rice which he has sold is actually 950. So if you find out the difference or the profit is going to be 250 rupees. Divided by what is the CP, actual CP is 950 into 100. So if you calculate this, 0 and 0 will get cancelled, 5 into 5, 19 into 5. So 500 by 19, if you calculate it perfectly, you will get the answer as 26.32%. So the answer will be C in this case. What just you need to do, you need to understand what can be the actual cost price. We have considered 1000 gram for 1000 rupees. So actual cost price will be of 950 grams only, which we need to consider, which is 950 rupees. Selling price we already know, which is 1200 because of 20% profit. And then we got the answer as 26.32%. This particular question was asked by Hima Bindu from SVP CET College. The question is related to simple interest. The question is, find out the capital required to earn a monthly interest of rupees 210 at 7% simple interest. So the question belongs to simple interest. The formula of simple interest, as we know, is PRT divided by 100, in which P is nothing but the capital or principal, you can say. R is the rate of interest which they have given 7%, and time is usually in years. And simple interest will be the extra money which one wants to earn. Now in this case, if you check, a monthly interest of 210. So I will consider simple interest as 210. Principal I need to calculate. Rate of interest is given 7. Now regarding years, as you can check, generally the T we always consider the time in years. But here we want monthly interest, so I can say time will be 1 by 12. My time will be 1 by 12 and into 100 as it is. So this is the only change which you need to understand. Time they have given in months. So for 1 month, the interest should be 210. So 1 month is nothing but 1 by 12 of a year. And now you need to calculate this. What will happen? P is equal to 210 into 12 into 100 divided by 7. So 7 into 3 is 21, so 30. 12 into 3 is 36, 0 into 100 means 36,000. So answer for this question, the principal will be 36,000. This particular question was asked by Anushtha Chaturvedi, Graphics Era University, Dehradun. The question is, Gauri went to the stationers and bought things worth rupees 25, out of which 30 paise went on the sales tax on the taxable purchases. If the tax rate was 6%, then what was the cost of tax-free items? Now one thing you need to understand, the total worth they have given as 25 rupees. So I will write total worth over here. Now, what can be the formula for total worth? I can say total worth is equal to cost of tax-free items. There will be some items on which we don't need to pay the tax. So cost of tax-free items, that will be the first thing. Plus cost of taxable purchases. So there will be some items on which I need to pay the taxes. So cost of taxable purchases and the actual tax which she needs to pay. So the total worth is equal to some items which are not having the tax, so cost of them, plus cost of taxable purchases, cost of the items I can say which are having taxable, which we can consider under taxable purchase, and plus the actual tax. So the total worth they have given as 25 rupees. Cost of tax-free items I don't know, I will consider right now it as X. Cost of taxable purchase and regarding tax. Now if you check the line, out of which 30 paise went on the sales tax. So 30 paise I can convert that into rupees. So I will consider it like 30 divided by 100. And if the tax rate was 6%, then what was the total cost of the tax-free items? So tax rate which they have given is 6% of the taxable purchases. So 6% of the taxable purchase. So tax rate, as you can check, she has given 30 paise, so I can write like 30 divided by 100, which is her tax. it is 6%, so 6 divided by 100, of taxable purchase. Suppose I will consider the taxable purchase as Y. So what will be the taxable purchase in that case? If you cancel this 100 and 100, I can say the taxable purchase is of 5 rupees. So cost of taxable purchase, which I have calculated right now, is 5 rupees. So what will happen? 25 is equal to X plus 5 plus 0.3. 30 paise means 0.3. So X will be 25 minus 5 minus 0.3, which will be 19.7 rupees. So answer for this question will be C, 19.7 rupees. From the given tax rate, you need to consider or you need to calculate the cost of taxable purchase items. Once you do that, it will be very easy for you to calculate the cost of tax-free items. So the answer will be 19.7. If you like this video, click on the like button. For any doubts, suggestions or feedback, please comment on this video and subscribe to our channel to stay tuned to various placement updates. Press the bell icon for notifications. Thank you.